Suffering from man boobs can be one of the most embarrassing conditions and can severely affect a man's quality of life. So in this video, what I'm going to do is take a look at some of the major causes of gynecomastia, aka man boobs, and hopefully present some of the most cutting edge health information that you'll struggle to find on Google. So please be sure to hit that subscribe button down below, as I do aim to release very cutting edge health information. So ultimately, in today's video, what I'll do is take a look at man boobs. We'll dive into some of the background research. We'll have a look at some of the potential causes, and so hopefully shed some light and some inspiration for those men that are suffering out there. So first of all, what is gynecomastia, aka man boobs? Well, we can see in this picture here, there are many different types of gynecomastia. You'll see different types based on body composition, based on the hormonal levels. We'll see different types based on general genetic susceptibility. You'll see different types based on the type of, I guess, steroids that men are using. And also you'll see different types based on skin complexion, skin tone, and other parameters related to water retention. So we can see here that there are many different types of gynecomastia. Unfortunately, a lot of men suffer from hardening of the actual nipple and an enlargement of the mass in that breast area. So there are many causes of gynecomastia, but what we need to do is take a look at the major stimulatory and inhibitory factors associated with gyno. There are many factors that can influence gynecomastia. There is no single cause of gynecomastia, and we need to acknowledge that both lifestyle and genetic susceptibility can influence the development of man boobs. So how do we actually test for gynecomastia? There is a simple test that doctors can perform where they actually pinch the area around the nipple and they can feel and observe and palpate, I guess, a hardening or a mass formation. Basically, what happens is there's an actual, a concentric mass formation that appears around the actual nipple. And this is different to the feel or the actual sensation, the actual tone of the other region of the chest. So we know that there's certain ways to identify gynecomastia through this particular test, but otherwise men can simply just observe. There are, you know, typical cases where we can literally just observe gynecomastia. We've seen it in many professional athletes that have abused steroids and even some SARMs. And again, just don't forget, there is an uprise in the use of testosterone and steroids and SARMs. We're also seeing a rise in gynecomastia, which is a great reflection of how these compounds can influence our hormones and ultimately affect our body composition. So there is something known as fake gynecomastia. We can see it's called pseudo gynecomastia there on the right, which is a buildup of fat that often manifests around, behind, or underneath the nipples, whereas there's no mass beneath the nipple itself. This generally develops due to just excess body fat in and around the breasts, and the entire breast is eventually enlarged. Whereas true gynecomastia is growth of the actual breast tissue due to changes in our hormones. So what happens is there's a presence of a firm mass of tissue underneath the areola, and it feels different from the fatty tissue around it. So you can see there the actual gland develops and enlarges. And again, like I said before, this is palpable. We can actually feel that there's a firm mound of glandular tissue around that areola area, and is in general can be painful to touch, or it can also be sensitive as well. So let's take a look at some of the stages of man boob development. We can see that the actual development stages tend to be a general enlargement. So we see that grade 1 is a small enlargement without skin excess. Grade 2A is moderate enlargement without skin excess. Grade 2B is moderate enlargement with minor skin excess. And then grade 2B is marked enlargement with excess skin, mimicking female breast ptosis. So we can see those different stages there. So the very first cause of man boobs or gynecomastia is having high prolactin and or low dopamine. You guys have heard me talk about the importance of dopamine. So this particular study is titled Causes of Gynecomastia in Young Adult Males and Factors Associated with Idiopathic Gynecomastia. Now, what's really important to note is the relationship between dopamine and prolactin. Here we can see how prolactin surges following orgasm in men. So immediately after a man ejaculates or, you know, has an orgasm, he releases a large amount of prolactin. And what actually happens is dopamine heightens and rises just before orgasm. In fact, it peaks just at the brink of orgasm. And this is why what happens is prolactin tends to rise, dopamine tends to fall. So in general, we know that dopamine, in particular dopamine D2 agonism, the dopamine receptor D2, by agonizing this particular receptor with cabergoline and other bromocriptine and other pharmacological agents, we see a suppression in prolactin due to a rise in dopamine. What's really important to note is that there are certain serotonin boosting herbs and drugs, you know, release serotonin. And in general, there's a positive correlation between high serotonin and high prolactin. So we really need to be modifying and, you know, tweaking our neurotransmitters if we want to affect our body composition. You guys have heard me talk about cosmetic neurology. This is really important. We need to be manipulating our neurotransmitters to eventually influence our body composition and even our just general health. The next major cause of gynecomastia is actually high progesterone. High progesterone is somewhat rare in men, but interestingly, in this particular study, it's sort of looked at prolactin secretion and gynecomastia. This article was in Bulgarian, but I did manage to get it translated. Contrary to healthy subjects, the patients with gynecomastia had significantly higher levels of follicle stimulating hormone and progesterone, whereas testosterone was actually reduced. So I'll get to the testosterone side fairly soon, but again, this is another biomarker that men who suffer from gynecomastia or man boobs need to be observing and checking a blood test. High progesterone can be a result of poor adrenal function or certain herbs, certain supplements, they can increase progesterone. So that's definitely something men need to watch out for if they're suffering from man boobs. The next major cause is actually something I've discussed briefly before, is xenoestrogen buildup. Xenoestrogens are basically super concentrated versions of estrogen. They're actually subtypes of estrogen, and they are a lot stronger than estrogen that the body produces. And they can downregulate the androgen receptors, affect prolactin, affect estrogen receptors themselves. And in general, this buildup of xenoestrogens, which we find in plastics, tap water, if we microwave those Tupperware containers. Just a side note here, even though a lot of these have BPA-free, companies will just use a different type of plastic. They'll literally just use like BPB or a different type of plastic which doesn't have enough research on, so they can use it. We want to be eating and drinking from glass. Prefer to use glass because we're not going to have any leaching of plastic there. So we can see that this study was titled Modulation of Prolactin Expression by Xenoestrogens. So xenoestrogens can affect our prolactin expression, which is, again, not something men want to have elevated. The next major cause of gyno is actually having low DHT, or if they're using DHT blockers. If you're a man and you want to feel like a man, there is no way you can feel, like have the mental benefits of the alpha male feeling by having low DHT. It's impossible to feel good as a man with low DHT. Again, I'm going to get a lot of people saying you're wrong and things like that. But if you look at the research and have a look at the benefits of DHT in the brain, how it modulates GABA, it affects norepinephrine, it's anti-neuroinflammatory. Let me go through this particular diagram to quickly explain it. So we know the different pathways of testosterone. So obviously in the brain, it starts with gonadotropin releasing hormone, which then releases luteinizing hormone. And then the testes create testosterone about 5 to 7 milligrams per day. Now, bear in mind, the testosterone can get converted either to DHT or to estradiol. Now, what happens is if we block the conversion of testosterone to DHT, it's telling the body that there's more resources allocated to that estradiol pathway, which is the stimulatory pathway for breast development. We have seen cases of gynecomastia with many DHT blocking herbs and drugs, and this is why DHT blockers can exacerbate man boobs. This particular study was titled Finasteride-Induced Gynecomastia, Case Report and Review of the Literature. Now, finasteride is, in my opinion, the devil's drug. Unfortunately, this particular medication, which is used to treat hair loss, unfortunately has a plethora of side effects that can last for years, even after withdrawal of the medication. So this is a perfect example of how a DHT blocker like finasteride can cause gynecomastia. I want to talk about specific herbal supplements. There are various herbal supplements such as reishi mushroom, lion's mane, pumpkin seed oil, blackcurrant oil, green tea, rosemary extract, saw palmetto, and potentially even Eclonia carva, although that one there is less risky. These particular herbal compounds contain natural DHT blockers, and in some cases, these can worsen gynecomastia for men that already have low DHT. So again, this is where we need to be really careful with recommending DHT blockers, particularly for men that are susceptible to low DHT. Another pathway that can contribute to gynecomastia is actually growth hormone increasing compounds like MK677, ipamorelin, and some other peptides that can release growth hormone. Now, this particular pathway is related to the IGF-1 pathway. Buddy, more plates, more dates. Derek has spoken about the IGF-1 pathway in great detail. Check out his channel if you haven't already subscribed to him. This IGF pathway is looking at the downstream effects of having high IGF-1. It can have sort of a stimulatory action on breast tissue, and this is a pathway that's often ignored. So again, it's really important that men get their IGF-1 levels checked through a blood test, because there are many compounds, as I mentioned, like MK677 and other compounds that can increase growth hormone and potentially increase IGF-1. You can see here, this diagram looks at growth hormone is a precursor to IGF-1, and then IGF-1 is produced in the stroma, and that can also contribute to breast tissue development. Interestingly, the next major cause is actually liver dysfunction. This particular study was titled Gynecomastia Associated with Cirrhosis of the Liver. Now, you guys need to take in mind or bear in mind that the liver's major function, or one of its major functions, is to eliminate excess estrogen from the body. The liver plays an important role in the metabolism of various drugs and hormones. So what actually can happen with liver cirrhosis is we can see an impaired ability to detoxify the body of estrogen. And we know that estrogen in general is stimulatory to breast tissue development. The next major cause is excessive alcohol intake. This particular study was titled The Effect of Alcohol Ingestion on Hepatic Aromatase Activity and Plasma Steroid Hormones in the Rats. In general, a lot of alcohol, unless it's hard alcohol like spirits or like vodka and gin, these tend to be the better forms because they don't contain a lot of the phytoestrogens that are present in beer. In fact, beer is the most anti-masculine drink on the planet. I don't see beer being beneficial for men in any way at all. So we know that patients with alcohol-related liver disease are at particular risk of gynecomastia because phytoestrogens in alcohol and the direct inhibition of testosterone production by ethanol further disrupts this estrogen to testosterone ratio. Very, very small amounts, however, very small amounts of alcohol can actually transiently increase testosterone, which is pretty interesting. Again, we're talking maybe like one tiny glass or one small serving of alcohol. Interestingly, the next underground or unknown cause is actually having low vitamin B1 and vitamin B2 status. This particular study was titled The Effect of Vitamin Deficiency on Estradiol Inactivation by the Liver. And interestingly, this study basically mentioned that our results clearly demonstrate that of the vitamins tested, riboflavin and thiamine, so B2 and B1, essential in the metabolism of estradiol by liver slices. The inactivation of estradiol is dependent upon the concentration of these vitamins in the liver. So here's another link here. So Alcohol can deplete vitamin B1, and if B1 is needed with B2 to inactivate estradiol in the liver, then if we have low B1 or B2 status, we're gonna see poor ability to inactivate estradiol in the liver, which is really fascinating. So, can gynecomastia be truly reversed? Unfortunately, in the most extreme circumstances, surgery is the only solution for some men. However, based on the things that I've discussed in this video, by removing the major stimulatory inputs and increasing the inhibitory factors, such as boosting DHT, boosting total testosterone, modulating estrogen, modulating prolactin, growth hormone, IGF-1. There's many things that contribute to gynecomastia. Don't forget that blood work is absolutely essential. We need to be getting blood work to identify our levels. And also keep a lookout for certain compounds and creams. I will be leaving a link to a raloxifene cream as soon as it's released. Planning on sharing that because that has some potent efficacy or potent effects at actually reducing gynecomastia. So that will be linked in the video description down below as soon as it's released. Thanks guys for tuning in. Hopefully you learned something new, and I hope that I've helped men who are suffering from gynecomastia, as it can be a very embarrassing condition. All right guys, peace out.